Radhe Govind, my dear students, today we are going to discuss the network layer design issues. So the basic purpose of network layer is to provide end-to-end communication capability in contrast to machine-to-machine communication provided by the data link layer. This end-to-end is performed using two basic approaches known as connection oriented or connection less network layer services. So we will discuss about them later. The four issues that network layer should address are: first, interface between the host and the network, that is the subnet. The network layer is typically the boundary between the host and the subnet. Subnet is nothing but the part of the network in which the destination device exists or we are moving from that part of the network. And second is the routing of the packet. Third is congestion and deadlock. And fourth is inter-networking, means a path may traverse between different network technologies, for example Ethernet, point-to-point link, etc. And the network layer should address this issue of different networks, so that the packet may traverse in this heterogeneous environment. The network layer interfaces uses two basic approaches for sending the packets. The packets are nothing but the chunk of the message that include data plus source and destination address. So the basic two approaches to send this packet are, it can send it by using connection oriented virtual circuit from node to node, or by the datagram method, which is connectionless. So in virtual circuit or connection oriented approach, a route which consists of logical connection is first established between two users. During this establishment phase, the two users not only agree to set up a connection between them, but also decide upon the quality of service to be associated with the connection. So the well-known virtual circuit protocol is the ISO and CCITT X.25 specification. The datagram method is a it is a self-contained message unit which contains sufficient information for routing from the source node to the destination node without dependence on previous message. That means the first chunk of the same message can travel from the different path instead of the second chunk of the same message. So in contrast to the virtual circuit method, where fixed path is explicitly set up before message transmission, sequentially transmitted message can follow completely different paths. The datagram method or the connectionless method is analogous to the postal system, as we discussed in the earlier classes, and the virtual circuit method is analogous to the telephone system, in which every chunk of the packet, or you can say packets are the chunk of the messages, so they will go in the sequence in which they are sent by the sender in the same path. Now the we will discuss these issues of the network layer. The another issue is routing. So the routing algorithm is the piece of the software that decides where a packet goes next. That means which output line or which node on a broadcast channel. For connectionless networks, the routing decision is made for each datagram packet. For connection oriented network, the decision is made once at circuit setup time. So the another routing issues are the routing algorithm must deal with the correctness and simplicity of the network. Networks are never taken down. Individual parts, links, routers may fail, but the whole network should not. Second is stability. If a link or router fails, how much time elapses before the remaining router recognizes the topology change? So the our network should sustain the topology for some time, even if a link or router fails. Fairness and optimality. In this issue, we will address an inherently intractable problem. Definition of optimality usually doesn't consider fairness. Do we want to maximize channel usage, minimize average delay? When we look at routing in detail, we will consider both adaptive or non-adaptive methods. So adaptive routing algorithms means they are reactive according to the network scenario, and non-adaptive algorithm means they are the proactive routing algorithms. So we will discuss about them later in the chapter. Now the next issue is the congestion. So network layer also must deal with the congestion. When more packet enters an network area than can be processed, then delay increases and performance decreases. If the situation continues, the subnet may have no alternative but to discard packets. So this is called congestion in the network. If the delay increases, the sender may retransmit, making a bad situation or even the worse situation, because it will not receive the acknowledgement from the receiver. So it may think that the packet is lost, so it may retransmit the packets, which may increase the congestion. So the overall performance degrades because the network is using resources or wasting the resources processing packets that eventually get discarded. Finally, we consider internetworking issue. Internetworking means connecting different network technologies together. One finds the same problem. Only worse, packet may travel through many different networks. Each network may have a different frame format. Some networks may be connectionless and other may be connection oriented. So interconnecting these heterogeneous networking aspect is an issue in network layer, which is to be addressed. And the next is, again, we discuss about the routing algorithm. So there are two type of routing algorithm. One is adaptive algorithm, and second is non-adaptive algorithm. Adaptive are algorithm uses the dynamic information of current topology, load, delay, and according to them they select the routes. In non-adaptive or proactive algorithm, or you can say static algorithm, route never change once initial routes have been selected. So we will discuss about these static algorithm in the chapter. And basically routing is concerned with the question, which line should router J use when forwarding a packet to router K? So it is all about the network layer design issues. And as you know that we are referring the material and videos of SWAM portal made by the IIT Kharagpur. So be tuned with those videos and material, and stay home and stay safe. All the best, student. Next time we will discuss in detail the all network design, network layer design issues in detail. Thanking you. All the best.